Hello everybody, I just thought I'd do a little film of the gallery. We're just outside now after closing time. Those are the doors to the Orchard Cafe, now obviously empty. Let's pass this big olive tree and there we have our sign, Peter Barker Fine Art, my name emblazoned across it. And around to the left there's a David Cowdery painting, oil painting of common carp. Round to the right on the other window board is a pastel Michael Norman. Now we go through the front door, usually around to the right here. One of us is sitting by the desk there. It's closing time now, but all is quiet. But when we are here, people usually come in and turn straight round to the left for the solace of the small gallery. And let's have a look. There we are. Let's just start here. There's a Trevor Lingard watercolour, Jennifer McChristian oil, and another oil, Leslie Stones, another Trevor Lingard at the top watercolour. Just pan up here. And Michael Norman pastel, another Trevor Lingard. At the top, one of my paintings I did last year on the Isle of Skye. And another one of mine, Paul Lockweir. And a little one just done recently in the snow. And oil by Trevor Lingard. And on the window board, pan out a little, there's quite a large oil, well, 16 by 22 oil of mine, an Angler in the Frost. And we pan around here on the far wall, there's a Haley Jo Summers painting, somewhat Christmassy painting, the top, and another one of mine underneath, a Robert Bashford. Robert Bashford's known for painting puddles and he's very good at it. I'm sure he's got a lot of subject matter recently. And there's another Trevor Lingard, an oil of mine, and a Robert Bashford watercolour. Rarer than hen's teeth. Nigel Fletcher oil at the top. Another oil of mine. And David Pilgrim oil. And his trips to Cornwall, and down the bottom, that's an oil painting by Deborah Tilby, a Canadian painter who used to live in this country for a short while, a couple of years. Now she's back home in Canada. And there's another jewel of a painting by David Pilgrim, and right above, a David Curtis. Oh, we're just spoiling you here. There's a still life, a rare still life by Graham Webber. Another gorgeous little garden study from Nigel Fletcher. And another beautiful little oil by David Pilgrim. And another David Curtis painted in the lakes when he went up there a couple of years ago in the summer. There's another Graham Webber here. Little oil by Robert Bashford. And here's a new artist we've taken on very recently, Nick Grove, who hails from Oundle, and that is a painting of West Street in Oundle. And another one of mine at the top of the local reservoir here, Ibrook Reservoir. Panning round the Trevor Lingard, really reminiscent of John Yardley. And there's a classical Norfolk landscape by Graham Webber. At the bottom here, an easel. A Jennifer McChristian from Los Angeles, and another one of hers just below. A fabulous oil painter. There's another one of Trevor Lingard's. And above, a Mark Preston. And above at the top, a lovely watercolour of Venice, unmistakably Venice, by Gerald Green. Trying to avoid the furniture here. There's another Norfolk painting by Nick Grove at the bottom. John Lines, and at the top a pastel of mine, and next to that another gorgeous pastel of Gorse Bushes by Michael Norman, below another pastel of mine, Padstow, and there's an oil of Kachewitz by Derek Daniels, and another one of John Lines, and at the bottom, kneel down for this one. This is a local artist. This is an acrylic painting by Keith Hensby called Death by Moonlight. And now on the sidewall, another cafe scene of Trevor Lingard. Another one of Trevor's called Beach Babes, which I just absolutely love this. Look at that. Not the usual Beach Babes you might think, but what a painting. And above that, Leslie Stearns, and two more of Nick Groves' Norfolk paintings, and a lovely little pastel by Robin Mason. Above that, one of John Lyne's classical industrial backstreet scenes called Poor Talbot Chips. Just going close, you can see the chip van there, just great. Trevor Lingard. Classical period piece at the top, and there's another gorgeous Nigel Fletcher. Can't believe we haven't sold that one. And this one, and again, I just can't believe we haven't sold. This is Jennifer McChrystal, one of my absolute favourite paintings, called Night Owl. Just great. And another Robin Mason. And just around here, as we walk in, is James Green, another local artist from Whittlesea, one of his acrylic ink paintings, and above that, a gorgeous jazz painting called Drifting by Jamal Akib. And I just walk around the other side of the upright easel, a ballerina, which Jamal does so beautifully. This one's sold. So now let's go through into the main gallery, or the larger gallery. That's another little Nick Grove painting, floating frame. Yeah, another one of Carl Terry's, and a puddly one, Robert Bashford. And now go around the table, try to avoid kicking the furniture, as they say. So gorgeous Deborah Tilby, two side by side, and two above are by yours truly again, and above that another Jennifer McChrystal and a Nick Grove, another Norfolk one. And now if I move back onto the far wall, just pan out, you can see it's a darker wall and the lighter painting show up so beautifully on this. That one at the top is another Gerald Green Paris painting. Look at the light on that. And there's another watercolour by Trevor Lingard. Trevor's a keen cyclist himself, so he's very adept at doing these racing scenes. And there's a oil painting by Leslie Stearns, a model boat maker. Move into this one. This is another exquisite one by David Pilgrim from his Cornwall trip last year. Next to that, a Derek Daniels oil, another Trevor Lingard. And at the top, a Mark Preston acrylic. Move out of the way of this, and there's another gorgeous London scene by Gerald Green, watercolour, a Hannah Merson oil. Just move in slightly. Kids playing the River Trent. And another Trevor Lingard watercolour of Derwent Water, very moody. And we've just got this one in from Louis Morris. A charcoal preparatory study for an oil painting. Brilliant in its own right. And another Trevor period piece. Now we pan over, and there's our wood burner there. And pan over to the long wall, and there's a Peter Brown, affectionately known as Peter Street, of course. Down below on an easel is one of David Miller's famous fish paintings. And there's a John Lyons straight landscape. And above that, another bright, vibrant acrylic painting by Mark Preston. And another absolutely superb small oil by Nigel Fletcher, who used to be my next door neighbour when we lived in Banbury and Bodicot. And below that, one of John Lyons' more humorous paintings. I pan in, you can see the chap there with his mouth open, and he looks somewhat ravaged. He's been shaken to death by the Rotavator, and of course the title is Mr. Rotavator. And below, a little oil study of old Harry Rocks by David Pilgrim. Down below that, pan out for this one a little. One of Peter Street's paintings of Bath. And above that, a great big charcoal study of Tusker by Jim Al-Akib. And next to them, another Pete Brown, gorgeous painting of Islington. And above that, another one of mine. A little closer. That was a demo piece I did last year. And above that, a lovely oil painting of David Pilgrim again. Look at that light on that building, the roof. Gorgeous. And another exquisite little oil by Nigel Fletcher. Below that, Deborah Tilby, and another one of David Pilgrim. Look at the light on that. And over here, just above the plan chest, another David Pilgrim old Harry Rock painting. And there's one of my pastel paintings of a pig called Porcine Glance. You see the look in his eye. And if I go down here, you can see that's featured on the front cover of my calendar. And now we have another Robin Mason painting, pastel, with the light on those windows. Gorgeous, catching the bright sunlight. Exquisite. And another puddly painting by Robert Bashford, this time in summer. And there's another Nigel Fletcher, and a wintry one of mine. Sun pouring through that big oak. And then another exquisite oil by Jennifer McChristian. Look at the movement in that arm. Isn't that just great? And the glint on the cue, called cue ball. Not surprisingly, beautiful painting. Another travelling guard. Another one of mine, little oil. And another Trevor. Beautifully loose watercolour. And next to that is an iconic view of Ply Mill in Norfolk by Nick Grove, and a new boy. And there's another bright, vivid acrylic painting by Mark Preston, and another Deborah Tilby. Below that, fabulous David Curtis painting, unmistakably. And next to that, equally unmistakably, a painting of Varanasi by Pete Brown, the light on that from one of his Indian trips, and another Mark Preston above. Down below here, I've got another oil of Who, Doctor Who. Who, Devon, isn't it? By Derek Daniels. And a great big acrylic ink painting of two cock pheasants fighting in the snow by James Green. And now, I go around here, that's the door through into the cafe, they say, black at the moment, all closed. There's a Roy Connolly oil, Trevor Lingard, another Robert Bashford, and another Robert. Trevor, I've got a lot of these little watercolours at the moment of Trevor's. Exquisite. I'm using the word exquisite too much. They are exquisite. Another one for those washes. And how about this for a still light? Let me just pan out a little.
Jar of Fruit. Just makes you want to go and pick those up. That's by Neil Carroll. Classical oil painting. And another one of Jennifer McChristian's above. And there's Wedding Kiss. The Travelling Guard. And another wonderful David Curtis painting of Cassis. And if I just move back behind the desk, at the top there above the window is a gorgeous oil by Tina Morgan. Another lovely artist from Devon. And another classical cafe scene from Trevor Lingard. A ballerina charcoal sketch by Jamila Kip. And how about this one? Isn't that terrific? By Gillian Roberts. Wonderful work. Crabbing in Whitby. Painted on site. All those people milling about. Just great. I don't know how she does it. Well, there's another classical cafe scene from Trevor Lingard. In the middle, painting of mine, Buttermere oil painting. With haystacks in the background. The mountain, that is, not actual haystack. And there's another one. I thought we would have sold this winter in all the snow. Lovely painting by Leslie Stones, for one of his next to it. And charcoal sketch by Jamila Kip. And below, another wonderful light-filled painting, watercolour by Gerald Green. And here on the big central easel, I'll pan out for this one, another ballerina study by Jamila Kip, sold. And another one on the other side, back to back, also sold. Fantastic. And nearly completed now. We've got the Trevor Lingard at the bottom. Look at those washes. An oil by David Curtis. And another Trevor Lingard cafe scene. Then above that on the window board, which we painted crimson for Christmas, and we quite like it. And that's an old painting of mine at the top of a local scene, an old mill, and below three little 6x8 oils. And the left and the right hand one painted a couple of weeks ago in the snow and the frost, in the middle one of a local village. And now back to where we came in through the front door. That's another lovely charcoal sketch by Louis Morris, and above, and Nick Grove, not Michael Grove, Gove. And there's a pastel painting of a Highland Bull by yours truly, and one of Pollock. Here below, gondoliers. The inimitable Trevor Lingard, another cracking, vibrant painting by Nick Grove, and on the other side, another one of Nick's, tremendous painting, quite reminiscent of Edward Seago, that one. And there's another Robert Bashford watercolour, and four to go, I believe. Another Trevor Lingard, a David Curtis watercolour this time. Team Method, look at all the work in those roofs, just great, the light singing off them. And another David Curtis oil next to it, a very verdant one, look at the work in that, just gorgeous. Economy of brush strokes. And a really lovely painting by Jennifer McChristian, Curbside Kiss. Absolutely fantastic. And I think, oh no, there's a couple more here, isn't there? There's another one of mine on the wall as you come in, another one painted last week before, a little watercolour of Trevor Lingard. Another Peter Brown above the doorway there. And lastly, just a couple above all, the Trevor Lingard, Deborah Tilby. Cracking still life pastel by Liz Bulkwill and Robert Bashford. And I do believe that is it. I hope you've enjoyed this tour. I'm a better painter than I am cameraman, so anyway, that gives you a flavour. We'll speak to you again soon. Thank you.